Going to be a design talk on how to inflict trauma on your audience. So first, can you hear me?
No.
All right.
Microphone's off.
Are you sure? It's not off.
They have to batch me because the mic might.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's not a good start. Is it better now? All right. Okay. So this is a talk on design and communication in general. It's really intended as a guide and hints and tips on making presentations more entertaining. And so first, let's make it clear, do not take this personal. Well, if you do, come see me after talk and I will give you a free hug. The thing I want to stress here that I believe that design is everything, really. Pretty much you know this, we're in LGM, right? Design is the core essence of this series of conference. And I think that presentation is some form of art, and conveying information and emotion to an audience, that's some kind of social art. And bad design kills, basically. Some people have called that dead by PowerPoint. I see this daily as a student. Those are actual slides from some of the courses I've had in psychology. So what I'm going to do here is basically give some suggestions on how to do better. Basically, why do we attend conferences? We want to meet new people and learn stuff, basically, and be inspired. And drink large quantities of beer, depending on the people. But we, ostensibly, we don't really come for the slides. The slides are not the content. They're here to support. We often say they're visual support, but they are not the content. They're here just to augment the talk. So what I'm going to show now first is my personal taste in making. This is not a hard and fast Zen rule. Some of you might have heard the term Zen presentations. This is just a personal preference. Doesn't have any. It's not in any books. Well, I think. So basically, my personal concept for slides is to not use black text on white, and instead use white text on black, like this. Like this chess piece here. It's my personal style, and I think it gives me more flexibility for two reasons. First, because it's painful for the eyes to look at a white screen. I mean, look at this. How insanely powerful that projector over there is anyway. A presentation, basically, it's not a paper handout. If you really want to give something like paper, you may do something separate and give it at the end. And since this is not a paper medium, you can get rid of those silly limitations. I mean, there's no visible frame. It could be here. Actually, it is here. But it could spend the whole size of the conference room, and you wouldn't know. Actually, you wouldn't really notice. So I think it gives you more flexibility to either put some small objects that seem to float in midair, or really huge stuff on the screen. So that was basically my introduction about why I think that basically white on black rocks. But here are some more generic guidelines. To me, doing a talk is about instilling passion. This is what you want your audience to look like. Basically at the end or while you're doing your talk, ideally, you do not want them to look like this. And basically you want to shock your audience, and you have to think what you want them to leave with as a message. And you want to avoid stuff like bullet points and especially paragraphs full of text that basically say the same thing that you're going to see anyway, especially if it's small text, and that basically you can read already what I've said before I've said it. So look, here's the deal. If I wanted to read a bunch of text, I wouldn't need narration. Basically, what I do, if I see a brick of text, like I often see in my courses as a student, when I sit there and wondering what I'm doing here, is I end up not looking at the slides and just looking at the speaker. Because I want the slides to be a visual support and not a visual interference, which is often the case. So when you don't need any visual support, you just blank the screen with the P key or a blank slide. And I repeat, do not put text just for the sake of it. And if you do, make sure that your text has nothing to do with what you're going to say. So what I do here is I have separate presentation notes. Like, just like magicians don't reveal their tricks, I'll show you one of mine. It's this, basically. This is how you do magic. OpenOffice has a presenter console extension that you can install. I think Keynote and PowerPoint have this too. And this allows you to show a different screen to the audience than what I'm seeing right now. So there's no reason to look at the screen behind you, especially if you have another monitor here that shows exactly the same thing as this. And you have another monitor that shows you what the audience sees, what the next slide is, and your conference notes. So some technical details. It's a nice thing to do a rehearsal or two. Actually, I didn't do it for this talk. And to test your hardware before the presentation. So I took a spare screen at my home, and I tested the multi-head and the sound system because I need working multi-head for this to work. And I bought a presenter remote, a bit like this one. You can find them for $80 in the store or $20 from eBay, delivered to your door. This one is less cheap than mine. And also resist the temptation to start fleshing out and planning with Impress, PowerPoint, Keynote, whatever. You start by doing your brainstorming on paper or a plain text file or something, and this will give you a much better overhead view, and this will also make you lazy and prevent you from making 85 slides, which my teachers often do, and they skip half of the slides over because they don't have the time to talk. There's also the 30, 20, and 10 rule that is well known in the Zen presentation guidelines stuff that I think it was Gi Kawasaki that said it. Basically, your presentation should have text that is no smaller than 30 points. Your presentation should be shorter than 20 minutes, and it should have 10 slides. Well, I break the last rule at least. I think it pretty much depends on your contents and the fluidity of your speech. So in my case, I'm never able to fit in the 10 slides rule. So anyway, to recap, I think that you basically have to exert restraint and avoid revealing your tricks when you're doing a presentation. And I'd like to stress that I don't have the absolute truth. This is just a personal thing, especially the white text on black background thing. And that you should probably look up this presentation thing, like look up for Presentation Zen and stuff like that. I think there's a book called exactly that. You could look at the Zen of Presentation or Presentation Zen on Google, and there's tons of blog posts about this. And you can consider this as a design challenge. Now, instead of just dumping as much information as possible into your slides, it becomes a design challenge, and it's really fun. Well, it took me 3 hours to make 20 slides, but it's fun. And so, yeah, that's it, pretty much. Any questions, comments, or insults?
Just remember, it's a short talk.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah, 10 slides is ridiculous. I mean, I've often used 10 slides in a minute, depending on what's on them, right?
Yeah.
If you're just putting up an image and going, ha ha, and you want the next slide, what's wrong with that? You can put as many slides as you want. So I see the general point, but I noticed that you disagree with that yourself.
Yeah, I just presented the Gi Kawasaki rule of 30-20-10, but I don't even respect it myself, and I think it's really hard to fit in that rule when you're presenting complex stuff like software, for example. Or if you do stupid talks that have random images and random text appearing out of nowhere, like I do.
Could you go back to the slide that has the big block of text?
The big block of text. You haven't had time to read it?
No, I only get halfway through.
Let's see. Strawberry
Patty. One for this one.
That was the one with the huge block of text, and why am I even looking at the projector screen? Yeah. So, yeah, that's pretty much it.
Okay, great.